Hi, glad to see you today. Today we're gonna do a little sunset painting, and colors I have are, we have the cad yellow orange, Indian yellow, bright red, titanium white, brush out the way. Titanium white, Prussian blue, midnight black, Van Dyke brown, dark sienna, Elysium crimson, sap green. These colors I'm going to use for this painting. Make sure these paints are firm. They're not drippy, or see mine's a little slip in here, so I'll pick that up right now. Color we're going to use anyways. I'm going to just pick some of that up with my 1 inch. So it's gone. Go take that. Take the red out. Okay. Now let's take off with a 1 inch brush. And let's do a sunset painting with the water here and some tree. Let's just see what happens. So let's go, we're gonna go into some cad yellow. Some cad yellow and a touch of midnight black, and it'll make a green, beautiful green color. Make a beautiful green color. Let's go up in here. We're gonna have our sunset right here. We're gonna have a little part here. That's gonna be our one part. Okay, now without cleaning the brush, we're gonna go right into some yellow orange. In there, and you should get a nice green, a dark leafy fall green. Just gonna see it's that color. Alright, now we're gonna add our sunset more right here. Like these things equally much. Put this in here, it'll eat it up, so be careful. Now we're gonna go into some, without cleaning the brush, Indian yellow. I want some Indian yellow. We're really going into the yellows today. Put some yellow orange in that yellow color. Go into some midnight black. And now you should have a beautiful, you want these colors to get equally darker as we go. Okay. Now I'm just gonna do some crisscrossies. Oh, a little more black into that. It's too bright. There we go. Now this color is a lot darker. It's just a touch of titanium white. It's a bit too dark. There we go. Little crisscross strokes. Put some here. Kind of. Now let's say our water line's right. This is our water line, so I kind of passed it. Okay, we'll make that water. There we go. Now we're gonna go into some bright red. To our bright red. We haven't even cleaned the brush yet. Some of our dark color. Bright bright red, eat up your entire world. It's a gorgeous color. Eat up your world. Just need a little bit. If you add a bit black, too much black, like I did. I think I put a little bit too much black. That's okay. We're going to add some alizarin crimson. It's going to be even darker. So right here. Overlap this and then continually mix with the background color and that'll blend in. There we go. Now, let's go into some alizarin crimson. Some more of a pinkish color. This is now going to be a more of a lavender color. Gonna be a real lavender color. Touch more, maybe some bright red in it. Maybe our color where we did bright red in. Touch a dark sienna. There we go. Now that's a really dark red right there. Should look black on your palette. We're gonna do little X's here. Crisscross strokes. Here where we marked our little line. Go in here and we'll continually blend. Okay. Now we're gonna go into some solid midnight black. Solid midnight black. And some Prussian blue. And some Prussian blue. And this is a dark, dark blue. A dark, dark blue. It's a strong blue. Prussian blue is a strong blue. Little crisscrossies right here, and I'll blend it out. Doesn't matter if you get any here, we're gonna end up turning that into reflections. Okay, go right here. See that? Okay, now we have our basic little sky going. We have to do our little. The reflections are a lot darker, so. Go back into our color. Gorgeous dark color. It's really, really, really strong, so careful with it. Now down here in the water, it'll be a lot more. Doing it in the corner, so now we're going to go back into our yellow wash. I did not clean the brush yet. Which saves us a tremendous amount of time. Keep cleaning your brush. So we're gonna add in there. Our line. I'll try not to pass this. If you do, it's okay. Blend that out later. Okay, I'm gonna go into this color. This color. Really crisscross strokes. Sometimes blue. Crisscross strokes. It really helps. Right here. Go into here. Okay, I'll just fill in the spots. And I'm going to go right into a dark color. I went right into my crimson. And let's just. Our lens is right here, so already here, so it's okay if you didn't do. I'm gonna go in here. There we go. Now, I'm gonna clean brush. Now, let's say clean, dry, two-inch brush. Make sure it's dry. And we're going to go, don't put in any color. Start from the light area and work out. Start from the dark area and work in. Dark area will eat up your light part. So, We're gonna start here. Blend this. It's really nice blending. You blend it to one. You can't tell when one color starts and the next color stops. Blend the edges here. I'm gonna soften it here. And not get tough in this area. If you get tough, you're gonna lose your nice, beautiful, bright area. So, only a few hairs touching. This just blends it out. Reassures us a nice, even surface. Nice, even surface. I'm a dark color, snuck in there. Alright, now here, we'll do the same thing. Pretty area and look out. A little bit darker than this. Right into our crimson. There you go. Now we're gonna blend that out. And blend that out. And this is, we wanna kind of give it a nice watery effect. So we wanna make it really watery. We might add some water lines later. Who knows? Who knows? We might add a blue black line back there later. That's later, not now. Okay. Now let's see. We need a little land area, so just gonna remove any excess paint that we might have picked up. And go right into some night black. And then light brown, some dark sienna. Mm. Oh, look at that, I picked up a lot. Look where it went. Look at that. Okay. We're gonna make ourselves a color. Right here near the sap green, just pull out our sap green. Here's some sap green. We need a nice dark color. Be afraid to pull out your nice dark colors. Don't get a little nice. I'm gonna lose this. Look how much red I got. Now let's grab a touch more of midnight black. Just spice it up a little bit. I want this actual. Now, let's see where our land is going to be. So start with crisscross strokes here. Find where your little horizon is going to be. Look here and come in. That, and fill it in. You can make it wider. I want mine up here. You want yours there? Go ahead. Spot. Round it out. We need more of the dark colors. Up some more midnight black. Fill this in more. Oh, let's just grab some solid midnight black. Put it in here. Just to darken it. Darken the colors. Really darken this color. Alright. Now, I'm going to grab this and go from the outside in because paint is going to be really, really harsh lines here. So from the inside out. Had to find out you could kind of go up and down and then do this. Try not to do that even though you could get rid of it. Okay. Now we can. Now we can rub our lunch brush. Go, my shirt's dry. Just tap it on the palette so I can. I'm not putting any color on here. Tapping in case there's any excess color. Okay, now let's grab some. Pull out some sap green. Put it down here. Down here. Some titanium white. Just a touch. That's all I have on the brush. Just a touch of Van Dyke brown. Put it in there. Just grab a touch more of the sap green. Maybe some midnight black. I don't wanna darken it too much. If you darken it too much, no, it'll be horrible. I have a very bad distribution of paint. Look up some more sap green. There we go. One more yellow. So I'm gonna go a little yellow ochre. Turn a little more yellow. A bright yellowish. I'm gonna try to just tap some into the bristles. Tap some into the bristles, and now we're gonna have some grass here. So start here. What color? Start going here. Now it looks like nothing. But sort of draw little lines where you want your thing. There we go. Grab that. A little more color, a little more white, a little more sap green, more Indian yellow. Not Indian yellow, I'm gonna wash some black. Now we have a little more color. There we go, now we can start playing. Maybe these are little grassy areas that just float around. They just sort of sit there all day and watch the water. And you want to give the water. Now the water doesn't look like water here, but it will soon. Uh-oh. Did I get some in my hair? Swear the brush touched the side of my head. I don't know. Okay. Now, you know what? Oh, I got a better idea for this. Here, I'm gonna take this out. So the sun isn't shining everything. There we go. Now, it's a little better for me. Okay, now. I'm gonna tap in a little more. We're just gonna go right here. Just a touch of dark sienna. Okay. Alright, now we have a little color. Tap the little color in. You're just gonna tap the color in. If you don't have any more color, there's nothing wrong. If you don't have any more color on there, there's nothing wrong with going back and reloading your brush several times. Now this back here is a big open ocean. Okay, alright. Now, we're gonna grab our most grassy areas and pull upward. Maybe 3/4 of an inch. Not 3/4, maybe 1/4 of an inch up. Maybe only half an inch up. Go up like if I'll show you. Go up like that, it's not good. I have to redo that, just tap it in. Or if you don't want to do that, you don't have to. And I kind of want the water to kind of reflect these, so like I'll pull those down, pull that down, cover it. Pull that down. Just blend it across. Isn't a nice little tip? And add some water lines here so we don't look like water. Only we're gonna add some black here anyway, so need some blue, not black. But alright, now I got my federal plate. Now we're gonna grab our little number 6 fan brush, and this is a firm fan brush. These are not the little soft, delicate fan brushes. These are the firm, bouncy fan brushes. Quite stiff. All right, now I'll show you how to make evergreen trees. Okay, let's go into some. I'll mix with the knife. The old knife is my fun part. Okay, some Van Dyke brown. Ooh. Dyke brown. Thank God there's no mess down there. Oh, I'm lucky there's no mess down there. Okay. Some Prussian blue. Midnight black. I'm gonna a little more Van Dyke brown. And some dark sienna. Some alizarin crimson. You don't want too much sap green. Yep, that's a lot. That's all. That's all sap green we need. And just put it in here. And now we have a nice little dark green area. Now, if you want to know what color that is, here's a good trick. Grab some white with the color you have on the knife. And look what kind of color you have. So that's the color I have. I keep dropping my knife. Too much of a lavender. I wouldn't say lavender. It's too much green. And that's a blue in it. Now, you can check if you want that color. You could add more Van Dyke brown to that. And more sap green. See if you like that color. I see. I like that color. So I'm going to put it right in here. I want more Prussian in there. Prussian blue. More Prussian in there. More Prussian. Some midnight black. Some more. Oh, geez. I'm spending so much time mixing these colors. Dark sienna. And now we should have a nice dark. Oh, some lizard crimson. I almost forgot. And take a knife. Take a knife. So wipe my own knife. Wipe the knife. Gotta have a clean knife. Running out of time. Nope. Got 2 minutes left. Alright, now we're gonna grab a brush. Go into some of this color, some of our dark color that we made, and some of the bright color that we made. That's all going so fast. Some of the bright color, some more red and brown, some of this nice green color we made. Alright. Now we can just make some happy little trees. Take a little line where we want it. Start with the corner of the brush. Okay. And we have ourselves one little evergreen tree. Maybe we want some more. So put one right there. Maybe we'll have one more here. I like making these little fun evergreen trees. Fun to make. Okay. Let's have a little indication of one right here. So we'll have this here. Go. And now we need to make our water. We need our water line, make it look like water, so. Who should we do? Water? I'll do the water first, because I run out of time. Well, the water is more important than anything, so I gotta just draw that. Okay, I have my knife. Let's go right into some liquid white. I have some liquid white here, and we're gonna just maybe a little more. White. There we go. Caught a little ball of paint right on the edge of the knife. I'm just gonna cut in a little water, basically a little water line. Yeah, I should have done blue first. What the heck? It's okay. It's okay. I need some. Pressure. Hold on, I gotta keep holding it. Oh, so many things. Okay, I need to pull out my pressure glue. And just start going in here to make it look like water. I have to make this look like water. Just think like water. If you were water, what would you do? And we'll have a little island here with a tree to make it really look like water, so. Okay. Now we can make some water lines. Okay, I'm gonna put some here, maybe one right there. And maybe one here. Well, I had one. Maybe one right here, a little small water line. Right here. And we might have a little water line. Maybe one here, maybe one there. Okay. And we'll have a little island. So we have our 1-inch brush. Go into our little green color. For a nice little green color. Nice little green color. And we'll just plant in a little island. This here, so we could turn that into reflections. And some words. You have a little reflection. Now, pen brush. Let's go into our dark color again. Okay, our dark color, And let's put in a little tree here. It's not that big. If you want to make a reflection, kind of just plant him in here. Just plant him in here. Just plant him in there. You just pull him down. Pull him down with the fan brush. And go across very lightly. Across. Right, you have a little reflection. Happy. We have a knife, and we need to have some little stones, some little, there we go, we have some little water here, and, oh jeez, I picked up my color that I don't want. Alright, we're almost done here. There we go. And we'll sign that one with a little bit of bright red. I gotta grab some tape there really quick. I ran 2 minutes over. Not good. I get mad at myself when the videos are a little too long. Some crimson. I don't have enough bright red. So, right. Now, you can just color. And I hope you enjoyed this one. This is the first painting on the series, and if you enjoyed this one, and we'll be painting along with us each week. Date on there. 2019. There we go. I want to thank you very, very much for watching. And I hope to see you again in the near future. And happy painting. And God bless, my friend.